Today, we'll explore the transformations of linear functions. We're going to take a closer look at how transformations affect the appearance and position of linear functions on a graph. You'll learn about shifting, stretching, compressing, and reflecting linear functions and how these changes are represented algebraically. By the end of this lesson, you'll have a solid understanding of how to manipulate linear functions both visually and algebraically. Let's break down the different types of transformations that can happen to a linear function. Vertical shift. If we add or subtract a constant k to the function, y equals f of x plus k, the graph shifts up or down by k. Horizontal shift. If we add or subtract a constant inside the function, y equals f of x minus h, the graph shifts left or right by h. Stretching and compressing. Stretching or compressing a linear function changes how steep or flat the line appears by multiplying the function by a constant. Vertical stretch. When we multiply the function by a constant a, y equals a times f of x, the line becomes steeper if a is greater than 1. Vertical compression. When we multiply the function by a constant a, the line becomes flatter if the value of a is between 0 and 1. Reflection. This transformation flips the graph across the x-axis. By mastering these transformations, you'll be able to quickly recognize how linear equations change and adjust on a graph. Now, let's apply these ideas to some practice problems. Given the function y equals 2x plus 1, apply a vertical shift of 3 units upwards. What is the new equation of the function? Let's start with a simple transformation applying a vertical shift. We have the function y equals 2x plus 1, and we want to shift it 3 units upwards. A vertical shift means we will add or subtract a constant to the entire function. Since we're shifting the graph 3 units upwards, we add 3 to the function's output. After adding 3 to the constant, we simplify the function to y equals 2x plus 4. So, the new equation after applying a vertical shift of 3 units upwards is y equals 2x plus 4. Given the function y equals negative x plus 2, apply a horizontal shift 2 units to the right and a vertical shift of 4 units down. What is the new equation of the function? Now, let's make things a little more interesting by applying both horizontal and vertical shifts to the function y is negative x plus 2. We'll shift the function 2 units to the right and 4 units down. Remember, a horizontal shift changes the x variable, while a vertical shift changes the output of the function. Let's go step by step. A horizontal shift means we will add or subtract a constant inside the function. Since we're shifting the graph 2 units right, we subtract 2 inside the function. Next, we apply the vertical shift by subtracting 4 from the function's output. Now, let's simplify the equation. After applying a horizontal shift of 2 units to the right and a vertical shift of 4 units down, the new equation of the function is y equals negative x. A company tracks the amount of profit it makes each day using the given function p of x, where x is the number of products sold, and p is the profit in dollars. Due to an increase in production costs, the company expects a decrease in its daily profit and a reduction in the profit made per product sold. These changes can be represented by applying a vertical shift of 200 units down and a compression by a factor of 2 to the function. What is the new profit function? This problem asks us to apply both a vertical shift and a compression to a real-world linear function. Let's go step by step to solve this. We are applying two transformations here, a vertical shift downward and a compression. The vertical shift moves the entire graph down by 200 units, while the compression means we will reduce the slope of the line, compressing the profit per unit sold by a factor of 2. We first apply the vertical shift by subtracting 200 from the constant term. Now, we compress the function by reducing the slope. A compression by a factor of 2 means we divide the slope 50 by 2, resulting in a new slope of 25. The new profit function is P of x equals 25x plus 800, which corresponds to answer choice A. Great work! You've successfully applied both a vertical shift and a compression to a real-world problem, just like you might see on your test. We learned that shifting a linear function involves moving the graph either up, down, left, or right. Vertical shift involves adding or subtracting a constant k which moves the graph up or down. For example, shifting y equals 2x plus 1 up by 3 units gives us y equals 2x plus 4. Horizontal shift involves changing the x variable inside the function by adding or subtracting a constant h. This moves the graph left or right. For instance, y equals negative x minus 2 plus 2 represents a horizontal shift 2 units to the right. We saw how multiplying the function by a constant affects the steepness of the graph. Multiplying the function y equals f of x by a constant a stretches the line vertically if absolute value of a is greater than 1. Similarly, if the absolute value of a is between 0 and 1, the function is compressed. We also covered how reflections work. When we multiply a function by negative 1, the graph flips over the x-axis. For example, y equals negative f of x reflects the graph upside down. By practicing these concepts, you can confidently approach any test problem involving transformations of linear functions. Keep practicing and keep up the great work.